What up, boys? Today I'm going to be reading a story about a man with a funny mustache and his shenanigans while playing Hearts of Iron. Enjoy. Sha-pa-pa-pa-pa-pow went the machine guns of the Nazi soldiers, cutting down ponies by the thousands. "We must hold the line," the Nazi commander said in German. "They cannot reach the Führer." "Mein Kommandeur," said a low-ranking Nazi, probably like a private or whatever Nazis rank their soldiers as. "What is it?" cried the commander in his funny accent. "Speak, or be sent to the gulags." "I bring a message from the high command. The fucker is safe in the bunker with his family." "Mein Gott, finally! With the Führer safe, we can abandon this front, tear down the tents and vacate the trenches, and get the tanks. We are leaving!" The commander yelled, and his herpes fell off. He picked it up from the mud and said some more German bad words.
"Sir," said Flash Magnus.
"Report, soldier,"
said Shining Armor. "The enemy is retracting." "Very good. We lost some damn fine men today. But goddammit, their sacrifice wasn't in vain." "That was the good news?" "Okay, so what's the bad news?" "They managed to secure the ferry in the bunker. Our mission to kill Hitler cannot succeed while he's safe in a fortified fortress." "Damn it! All the lives lost were in vain." "Sir, there's more." "Spit it out, soldier." "Yes, sir." "Spit it out, soldier." "Yes, sir." "So what's the other news?" "Sir, there may be a way into the fortified bunker. It is the only fortnight on the outside, but there is a weak point if we can dig in with the help of Rockhoof." "My god, the man who died today may not have died in vain." "Sir, he already has tunneled halfway there. We may see things through yet." "Oh, captain, my captain." "Very good, Flash Magnus. You may at ease at 0200 hours in the mess hall, but don't go too AWOL." Both ponies laughed as Shining Gama's funny joke and Flash Magnus went for his shore leave in the mess hall.
"Sir,"
said the German at the station with lights and screens and stuff.
"Seismic activity detected under the ground."
"Is the earthquake machine acting up again?" replied the commander.
"Negative, sir. The radar is picking up the ponies under the ground. They are digging faster than our secret giant drill."
"What?
Impossible. This bunker is impenetrable. They will never make it through the concrete floors. Mein Gott, they are past our outer perimeters. They are directly below us."
The radar beeped and a little pony-shaped blob moved every time the scanning line thing went past it.
Boop-doop, boop-doop, boop-doop.
A bead of Nazi sweat formed on both their brows as they watched the dots move. Then it stopped. The commander sighed.
"Good, they are stuck at the..."
There was a loud bump directly below them, and a sitting down Nazi's chair jumped up a little.
"No more games!"
the commander shrieked at the top of Das Langens. He pressed the soldier button, and there were soldiers.
"Ready! Arm!"
All the soldiers aimed their M60 machine guns down at the floor.
"Fire!"
Every AR-15 went off at once, and the bullets swirled in the ground as the sounds of hundreds of AK-47s firing 50 caliber full metal jacket rounds filled the seismic radar room.
"They're closing in, 500 meters, said the scientist.
"Keep firing,
the captain ordered, and the soldiers pushed the triggers harder to make the guns shoot faster, and the commander could barely hear a pin drop among the noise of M16 rifles.
"We cannot let them kill the Führer."
400 meters.
400 meters,
the radio guy said.
"Surely.
Nothing could still be alive down there."
300 meters. They are almost inside the concrete. Do you men want to spend the next 100 years in the gulags?
The commander threatened, and the soldiers saluted and kept firing into the ground. Rockhoof dug like his life depended on it, because it did, because it was his duty as an American soldier.
Ach, can I break for the concrete like this? I've not seen rain so bad since the storms over Glasgow.
Rockhoof said in his thick American accent as he held his shovel over his head to block bullets from above. As a bullet hit his shovel, however, he could hear the way that it was, and he knew they were hollow point rounds, hollow like digging, which meant... He tilted his shovel just the right way so that the bullets went straight back at from where they were coming from, which... The dirt and concrete melted insanely and made a hole bigger than enough for him to fit through, and he jumped up inside the ferrified bunker full of Nazis, and they shot at him with their SMGs, but you know what they say, the shovel is mightier than the sword, so his shovel swung around in a circle and took out all the Nazis, and they stopped shooting because they were knocked out. And Rockhoof whipped sweat off his brow, and then suddenly a pin dropped and he knew it was too late because the grenade rolled in front of him and he gulped and said,
I'll miss you, Yona. And he was blown into tiny American smithereens.
His death won't be in vain,
said Shining Armor as he charged inside the bunker through the hole. Many Nazis were waiting with bayonets and muskets, but Shining Armor knew how to defeat Charlie was the element of surprise, the secret seventh element of harmony that was on his neck. So when he came, he yelled, "Surprise!" And the Nazis were surprised, and they had trigger finger frostbite, for they lacked Skinneranian training, unlike Shining Armor, and he stabbed them all with his spear.
"Ein Leben!"
they cried as they died. Soon, the holes were filled with dead Nazis, who spent the last moments twisting their bodies into shapes of swastikas so that their corpses could be symbolic of their eternal loyalty to Alfred Hitler. And then there was his door. It said AH in plastic letters. Shining Armor tried the doorknob, but it was locked. No matter, he was a former Navy SEAL and he knew how to make Semtex. He took out his MRE packs and went absolutely AWOL on them, ripping them to shreds and mixing together chewing gum, sugar, gunpowder, powdered zinc, flour, sawdust, and toothpaste. Soon, he had a small bomb that would do more than just knock on the door, if you know what I mean. "I bid you adore," he said as he hit the detonator. Beep! Kablowy bazoom! Door was reduced to steel splinters. Inside was Adolf Hitchcock and his family sitting on a couch shaped like a swastika. He was with his beautiful wife and three kids. They were all laughing and playing Connect Four.
"Damn it, nobody said nothing about no kids,"
Shining Armor lamented. He could kill a Nazi if he was 18 or over, but not kids. Nothing justified killing kids, not even doom music. He sank to the floor in a pile of puddle and sobbed like a real human, even though he was a pony, but human as in not a Nazi. Hitler and his family got away to safely back to deep Germany where no pony could find them.
"It seems they all died in vain,"
Shining Armor cried. And if he had a shirt, he would have ripped it off, but all he had was armor, and it was too strong to rip off, even for how sad he was then. One Nazi came around the corner, carrying a tray of Nazi tea and dropped it, and wet himself in fear, and Shining Armor killed him, and that made him feel a little better, but he was still inconsolable for the rest of the day. Back in war camp in his tent, with the generals to be specific, Shining Armor was crying, and the other military guy said, "It's okay, you did your best, etc." But Shining Armor knew he had to do more. There was always more. And besides, the war wasn't over. The real war has only just begun. So yeah, that was chapter 1, boys. Stick around for chapter 2 soon.